This episode of TechZilla is brought to you by the 3M streaming projector powered by Roku.
Hitman Absolution is here. So what's the word on the newest installation to this long-running series? The legendary games reviewer, Adam Sessler, a.k.a. the newest installation at Rev 3 Games, has the good word. So how's it going over here?
Legendary. I like that. It's like Zorro or that movie about owls.
That's great. I never saw the owl movie.
Yeah, I didn't either.
No.
Because it's just owls. I can go on the internet and get more than enough.
There's so many owls on the internet. How is Revision 3 treating you so far?
I am liking this.
Yeah?
I moved back to San Francisco, which is very nice. It's funnier. There's people I know. There's people I'm meeting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It really is a good time.
So getting back on track here a little
assassinations.
Bit.
Let's go from good feelings and hugs to assassinations.
Absolutely. So what's the point and how well does it play?
Well, I mean, Hitman has been around for a long time. I have fond memories of trying to play it when it first came out on PC in 2000. It was excruciatingly hard. Like, just getting out of the introductory sequence that teaches you how to play it was near impossible. That has changed over the years, where it's still about stealth and you're killing people silently, you're putting on costumes so people don't realize that you're a bald killer sent to kill. which is actually one of the more funny aspects of the game, and I quite enjoy that. But they've made it more accessible. Mm-hmm. Each iteration has, the controls have improved. They've been more thoughtful that people who don't have that much experience in games should also be able to enjoy it. And I think they've really kind of hit that sweet spot with this, where they have five different difficulty settings. So if you are hardcore, you like the old style, they can make it so hard that I believe no one who has actually made the game has succeeded in playing on that difficulty level.
They just do it to screw with people.
Exactly. There's that guy out there who has the time and will devote himself to figuring out how to do that. Mm-hmm. But they've allowed it where there's a dynamic way in which you can resolve situations. You can take a disguise, you can sneak around, you can be a little bit more aggressive in how you shoot people. The game allows for that, and this thing called Instinct Mode, which is brand new, which allows you to just kind of see points of interest in the room, get a sense of where the guards are positioned. That really, I think, is going to help for a lot of people that have been sort of stymied in trying to play these types of games. On the whole, it's fun, and there's that sense of creation. Yes, you are killing people, but you're like, I'll make the statue fall on him, or I'll climb outside the window, and I'll yank somebody out of it.
Oh, good. Creative murder, my favorite kind.
I know, this sounds completely sadistic and morbid, but I mean, they really have made it where you kind of do something, you're like, wow, I made that. I feel quite clever. The only downside I have to the game is it scores you, and that in and of itself isn't so much the problem, but it clearly gives an idea that there's a better way to play the game than other ways.
Okay.
And that kind of runs contrary to this idea of do it as you see fit, find your own play style and adapt to it. And that would have still been acceptable, except as you're playing the level, you'll see points taken away.
So not all murders are creative
right.
equal.
They really seem to want you to not kill anyone other than the target themselves. And
that kind of makes sense. I mean, you are a hitman.
Well, yeah, I know. You should be able to bill more, I think, from the client if you start to kill other people. But, I mean, it doesn't set that out as rules, and you start to see these kind of very disincentivizing red markers, fill the screen. Like, okay, you've lost this many points, this many points. And that kind of curtails that desire to experiment and to find other ways. So if you can somehow ignore that, you can replay the levels, and there's far more dynamic ways of resolving the problems at hand than you first realize, and it's quite something.
So now, I've never actually played this series before. What would you liken it to for people who may be new to it?
I would say the closest is somewhere like the Splinter Cell series, with a mixture, I think, of the more recent game Dishonored and Deus Ex.
Oh, I love Dishonored and Deus Ex, actually.
It's nowhere near as open as the opportunities are in those games. There, they just kind of set up the physics, set up your skills, and let you go. But it's kind of the middle of the two. It doesn't move as slowly as Splinter Cell and some of the more traditional stealth games, which I think is good, so that if you do screw up, restarting isn't this kind of, now I'm going to crawl across the floor.
So now, you mentioned PC earlier in the interview. Is it available on all the platforms right now?
Not Wii U.
Not Wii U, of course.
But yes, it is. And it looks absolutely astounding on all of them. But that PC, of course, has that edge if you have the hardware for it. And it's kind of, I think it gives you a sense of what the next generation of console games will be looking like.
So if people have a multi-platform situation at home, they should probably go with PC if that's available to them?
If visuals are your primary concern, I think for these types of games, what controller is your happy place, that's probably going to dictate which system.
About how many hours of gameplay is there?
I would say you can probably push 20. Mm-hmm. It's good in that You can find very quick and efficient ways to kill people. There's also some very sort of lugubrious ways that can be a lot of fun. Also, it really is fun to go back and replay the levels. They have badges and awards for doing certain things, and you really can't do it in one playthrough. You're going to have to go back and play it again.
What's that called when you set up one thing and then it knocks down the next thing and it goes around?
Yes.
What was it, Roger? No, not a domino.
Not a domino. It's a Rube Goldberg.
A Rube Goldberg machine. Yeah,
yes.
Can you do that?
There are elements that kind of play into that. Nothing. I haven't discovered
that
something
cool.
That elaborate, but you're giving me ideas I want to go experiment with.
I didn't actually expect there to be them, but I thought maybe you could hack something together.
No, it's like taking the game Mousetrap and Death.
I think we
altogether.
Have. I think
we have
a new title.
New franchise
I think that's a new franchise. Exactly.
Yeah.
So what about it does not get your seal of approval? What's kind of a downside to that game?
It's primarily this scoring system, which really just kind of I'm really big on encouraging the player to do what they want. You know, to look at a game both as having a point but also as a sandbox. And it has all those elements there and then kind of runs contrary to them with this scoring system. There's also some issues with where you get your checkpoints in the game, because these levels can be very long. They have checkpoints.
You can't save automatically?
No, you cannot.
Oh, I hate that.
There's good and bad to that, because yes, you have to devote a fair amount of time, but where there are checkpoints, they don't have them on the primary path. They're like in the broom closet. So not fighting the checkpoint areas is very easy, and you can realize you may have done really, really well in the game. Now you're about to die, or you realize you've been spotted, and you want to reload, and you have a lot of game you have to replay again.
That's always a pretty big pain in the butt. Well, thank you so much, and
what
can we look forward to over at Rev3 Games?
A lot more. The Wii U is out. Mm-hmm. Zombie U is going to be up on the site. I have my Cessler Something, which will get a name other than Cessler Something once some of you guys out there give me the best name in the world. A lot of stuff, obviously Black Friday is coming up this week, and so we're going to be giving some deal points about where to get games for cheap.
Awesome.
Because you're going to give them to your friends, right? No, they're not.
Yes, well, thank you so much for coming on the show. We'll definitely
have you
back on again sometime. I love talking games.
All right.
All right, we've got more of your questions still to come, but first, it's time to thank one of our sponsors.
It's time to experience your favorite online entertainment on the big screen with the 3M streaming projector powered by Roku. Let the magic of projection bring your friends and family together like never before. Enjoy your favorite movies and shows 120 inches across. That's like twice the size of most HD TVs. The built-in battery and Wi-Fi capability make it extremely portable. You can pack it in your bag and go. You know what's even better? The projector has a Roku streaming stick built in. That means you can project your Amazon Instant Video, Netflix, Hulu Plus, Revision 3 shows, and other favorites on any surface. A big wall in the living room, the side of your garage, the basement ceiling, the wall of the hotel room, anywhere you have Wi-Fi. Project shows and movies for a theater-like experience no one will forget. For more product information, go to bringepicback.com or check out the reviews and buy it now on amazon.com.